online on the church's website and Channel 13. Today is Holy Trinity Sunday that we celebrate in the church, and we are grateful for the worship team that is with us today as we join together in worship. We had a passing in the life of the congregation. Janice Lenhart passed away, and the service of life and resurrection is a private service, which will take place tomorrow here at Our Savior's at 2 o'clock. There'll be a public viewing that begins at 1 o'clock. Also, there'll be a joint council meeting for Our Savior's in Malo on Tuesday at 7 o'clock p.m. here at Our Savior's. We'll be discussing in-person worship. We are grateful to God for his continued faithfulness during these turbulent times, and in our prayers we'll be remembering those who continue to struggle with the pandemic and praying for peace for our state and for our nation. With no further announcements, we continue our service with our opening hymn, Holy, 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 and I invite you to take your bulletin, which was sent out by mail or email, to follow along in the service and to join with us as we sing hymn number 413.
Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, early in the morning our song shall rise to thee. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity. Holy, 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 all the saints adore thee, casting down their golden crowns around the glassy sea. Cherubim and seraphim falling down before thee, which word and art and evermore shall be.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and also with you. The word is near to you, on your lips and in your heart. If you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Faith comes from what is heard, and what is heard comes through the word of Christ. Let us pray. Almighty Creator and ever-living God, we worship your glory, eternal three in one, and we praise your power, majestic three in three. Keep us steadfast in this faith, defend us in all adversity, and bring us at last into your presence, where you live in endless joy and love. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first reading is from Genesis 1. Genesis 1:26, verses 2 and 3. Then God said, "Let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. So God created humankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, "Be faithful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth." God said, "See, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit, you shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given green plant for food." And it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed it was good. And there was good evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all their multitude. And on the seventh day God finished the work that he had done. And he rested on the seventh day from all the work he had done. So God blessed the seventh day and hallowed it, because on it God rested from all the work he had done in creation. Here ends the word of the Lord. We'll read this psalm responsively. It's Psalm 8. O Lord our God, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You whose glory is chanted above the heavens, out of the mouth of infants and children, and you have set up a fortress against your enemies to silence the foe and avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars you have set in their courses. What are mere mortals that you should be mindful of them, human beings that you should care for them? Yet you have made them a little less than divine. With glory and honor you crown them. You have made them rule over the works of your hands, and you have put all things under their feet, all flocks and cattle, even the wild beasts of the field, the birds of the air, the fish of the sea, and whatever passes along the paths of the sea. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Our Holy Gospel for this Trinity Sunday is taken from Matthew, the 28th chapter. Down through the weeks, we went through the Ascension, where Jesus ascended to heaven, Pentecost, where the Holy Spirit was given, and now we come to the Great Commission. This is taken from Matthew, the 28th chapter, beginning with verse 16. Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore, make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord. We continue with our children's message. And as typical, I need to put on my thinking cap. And as we think through Trinity Sunday, we think through the great love of God. I've brought with me a tape measure. Now, we use tape measures for many and various things. In our congregation here at Our Savior's recently, we received a generous gift to purchase gold pyramids for Easter. So we measured the lectern, and it came to 24 inches. We also use tape measures if we're building or if we're creating something. It's the summertime. I see a lot of garage doors open and people puttering away in the garage building many and various things. We also have been asked, given the fact that we are in COVID-19, to come up with our maximum capacity, which involved the measurement of our pews and how many people we can get per pew. And we figured we could probably comfortably seat about 8 people, maybe 10, probably 8. 8 people per pew? Yes. 8 people per pew is what we thought. And so measurement is used often in our world day by day. When we think of Holy Trinity Sunday, we think of God's love, where we cannot measure the height, the depth, or the width of God's love. It is immeasurable. And we are loved with an everlasting love, a love that continues on and never ceases. We continue with our hymn, Jesus Loves Me.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me, yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me, the Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me, he who died, heaven's gates to open wide. He will wash away my sin, let his little child come in. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
Grace to you and peace from the God who loves. Amen. Well, the past couple weeks have been turbulent ones for our state and our nation. We have all seen what has taken place some miles from us as we think of the reaction to the passing of George Floyd. We also continue to hear of the update of our pandemic, and we are grateful for in our community that things have kind of subsided some. I've been getting reports every day from the emergency management, and it looks like things are fairly stable. This next week, more businesses are going to be opening. And on Wednesday, the pool is thought to open possibly at 50%. So on Tuesday, our parish will be revisiting that once again, we will be gathering, I'm hoping, for in-person worship. I want to remind everyone that it will be a little different, and we have to kind of understand that given our time, but we are all great, flexible people and very able, and it'll be wonderful to get together again. This, however, will be sent out by letter to the congregation when a firm decision is made. On this Holy Trinity Sunday, we're reminded about God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. It reminded me of what happened some years ago. I taught a Sunday school class, and in my lifetime have had the opportunity to do pretty much every part of church ministry. And I remember the little boy in class when I shared with them Deuteronomy 6:4, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one." And he said to me, "When does he turn two then? When's his birthday?" And I thought, well, that's interesting. This little fellow kind of perceived things a little differently. But in the church, we speak of God as one in three persons, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. We will be confessing the Apostles' Creed in our service, where we highlight God the Father, Creator, God the Son, Jesus who died for us, and God the Holy Spirit, the Sanctifier. And as we think of Holy Trinity, we think of this verses that we read in Matthew 28, which is the Great Commission, to go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In that Great Commission, it highlights God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. So we have God the Father, God who created and made and sustains our universe. All that we see around us and the beauty of creation, the animals, the birds, the oceans, the seas, the lakes, the rivers, the streams, the sky, the sun, the moon, all that we admire about God's creation began with God. This is the summer, and I receive by Facebook and sometimes by text pictures from people at their lake homes. And the moon has been full moon most recently, and there's some beautiful pictures that show the moon over the lake and over the water. But we need to remember that God is the creative power behind the universe, that it was all created for a plan and for a purpose. And it will have a beginning, and it will have an end. In God, who is creator of the universe, God will also sustain the universe. It's interesting because in these days of COVID-19, it's been a mixture of weariness and blessing. And one thing that they have found that throughout the world is that since human life is slowing down, and since we are not driving like we normally do, that the earth and the atmosphere is literally healing itself. I've shared before that my younger brother lives in Los Angeles, and he went out for a walk, and he said for the first time in all these years that he's lived in LA, he saw the mountains. Because everything was slowing down. It's like this big deep breath and pause as the earth is renewing itself. So there's many perspectives to this pandemic that we are part of. God is master of the universe. He is also sustainer of the universe. And in that space, we live and move and have our being. When we think of God who is creator, it seems as though it is God who is unreachable, you know, beyond human understanding, unknowable. And so God became one of us in the person of Jesus, born in an overcrowded parking lot, I like to call it, in a stable in Bethlehem, born as a baby to show us the length and breadth of God's love. By Jesus coming into our world, he took humanity's fear of God away. If you study different religions, be it Buddhism, Hinduism, animism, one of the key principles in all those religions is a real fear of God. Not a relationship with God, but a sense that you are far away from God. And it is only in Christianity that we have God who comes down to be in our midst, and to walk where we walk, and to experience what we experience day in and day out. That means that as we are worshiping today, God knows every thought in our minds. Many of us may be ticking through our schedule for the day, going to have worship, after my coffee, going to see the family, might go to the lake, might go do errands. We have all sorts of things that we want to accomplish in that day. But isn't it wonderful as we gather for worship that we can say, Jesus, who is present in human life, show us today what you would have us to do. What is it that would be your will for us today? Jesus, who is present at the very depths of our sorrow. We have had three passings during COVID-19, Bill Bossman, Greg Kyland, and now Janice Lenhart. And in each one of these cases, it's been so difficult for families and even families who have loved ones who are ill because of the restrictions that are present. And when you're brought into a setting where your loved one is in the hospital and you can't see them and visibly be with them, you begin to understand more of the importance it was for Jesus to be physically, visibly present in our world. Because with Jesus physically and visibly present, he came and lived among us, was up to his armpits and all that human life brings and all its suffering and challenges, and engaged in all the facets and aspects of what living is like. With that, Jesus told his disciples that it was to their benefit that he would go away so that he could send the Holy Spirit, who is the Spirit of Jesus, to be with us. This means that we are never, ever alone. That God is with us through all the aspects and through all the trauma that life brings. Martin Luther said that we pray not because God needs to know about our situation, but we pray so that we are connected to God, so that we can begin to hear how God is leading us, caring for us, providing for us, and is present for us. That is found in the gift of God's Spirit, the gift of the Holy Spirit. One thing wonderful about the body of Christ, and you know, we've been worshiping in many respects the way the early church worshiped. We haven't stopped meeting as a church. Just because we're not in a building doesn't mean that we haven't been worshiping. We've been meeting in homes, we've been meeting in lake cabins, we've been meeting in all sorts of places, and worshiping just like they did in the early church. And we have continued to be a vibrant and growing community. Through online worship, it has reached out to many more people. During the week, I'll get calls to say, you know, Pastor Janet, I've never been in the Our Savior's building, but I've been listening to the services. And through our worship in this time, we have been reaching out and also serving our neighbor. Our Savior was so gracious to help with meals and to help with the food shelf. The telecare ministry, which prays for our senior members, we have about 50. And they are very much in isolation of sorts. So we need to kind of keep that in mind. But in reaching out and in serving our community, I think our town did a great job with graduation in honoring the kids who graduated so that they will remember their graduation and how unique it was. And they've told me that, you know, the class for next year may ask for the same thing, you know? They don't want to go back to the old ordinary. Let's go back and do something different. But with the presence of the Holy Spirit during this time, it is truly defining us even further as a vibrant, growing church, as a compassionate church, and a church that reaches out and serves the community. God's Spirit is present where you are. Maybe you're in your living room. Maybe you're sitting in your comfy chair. Maybe you're at the lake. But God's Spirit is present. And God's Spirit is at work in our lives in order to bring about positive change so that we can experience the resurrected power of Christ within us. This next week, I have a challenge for all of us. And the challenge is this. May each one of us reach one person, just one. Because think, if the whole population of Warren reached one person and meeting them at the point of their need, how our community could grow and change. Amen. And we continue with our next hymn.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God. Born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight. Visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending, spring from above. Echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long.
In Christ you have heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation. We believe in him and are marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. Living in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Build yourselves up on your most holy faith. Pray in the Holy Spirit. Keep yourselves in the love of God. Look forward to the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ. If anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. Behold, everything has become new. God has given us the ministry of reconciliation. Therefore, let us be reconciled to God and to one another. Gracious God, have mercy on us. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. Uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. This is the time in the service when we receive the offering, and we are thankful for all of your generous gifts as the ministry of the church continues, not only to our members, but also to our community. We continue with our prayer. Generous God, you provide for our every need. Receive our gifts of money, imaginations, and all we have to give. Amen. We continue with our devotional hymn, Lord, Listen to Your Children Praying.
Lord, listen to your children praying. Lord, send your Spirit in this place. Lord, listen to your children praying. Send us love, send us power, send us grace.
Called into unity with one another and the whole creation, let us pray for our shared world. God of counsel, all authority belongs to you. Encourage the leaders of this and every land to seek peace, equality, and unity. Instill wisdom in advocates who work towards justice and are in often ignored communities. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. God of care, You created us in your image. Help us to see your likeness in one another. Open our eyes to see and attend all who face oppression and suffering. Console, heal, and nourish all in need. We pray especially for Curtis, Carol, Florence, Glenn, Jan, Marlene, Pastor Ron, Tommy, Emily, Elise, Landon, David, Jana, Marla, and we remember the families of Greg, Claudia, Dorothy, and Janice. Hear us, O God. God of compassion, companionship, you accompany this body of faith. As the rhythms of summer begin, protect all who travel, renew all who enjoy the time of Sabbath, and shelter all who will not be protected from the sun's heat. Hear us, O God. God, we think of the turbulent time of our state, our nation, and our world. We pray that you will bring peace and understanding, dialogue, and communication. Heal the wounds that have been opened. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. We pray all who are suffering from the pandemic, bring healing and restoration. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. God of compassion, you comfort us in our grief with the promise of the resurrection. We give you thanks for all the saints of all time in our lives. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Receive these prayers, O God, and those too deep for words, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Lord, listen to your children pray. Lord, send your spirit in this place. Lord, listen to your children pray. Send us love, send us power, send us peace.
We join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Neither death nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. God the Creator, Jesus the Christ, and the Holy Spirit the Comforter bless you and keep you in eternal love. Amen. Go in peace. Christ is with you. Thanks be to God. We join with our closing hymn, When Peace Like a River.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul. Though still it is well with my soul. It is well, it is well with my soul. Though Satan should buffet, though trials should come, let this blessed assurance control, that Christ hath regarded my helpless estate, and as shed his own blood for my soul, it is well with my soul. It is well, it is well with my soul.